Rashka Reddy is the daughter of a scientific family. Her father was a surgeon, her mother a pediatrician. She started her career when she graduated from Cairo University in 1966 after studying at the Faculty of Science.
I was very lucky to be in a family of medical doctors. My father is a surgeon, was a surgeon. My mother is a pediatrician. And they are very characterized by a very high values of integrity. So, and they have taught me incorruptible integrity. Together with an excellent education in French school, where I also was lucky to follow, and a complete freedom. So I was freedom related to anything I would do in life. And this freedom has ended by the highest level of spirituality and dedication to high values one can usually achieve. I was taught by my mother not to differentiate between my three brothers and a girl. And I was taught not to be faced by such a difference. And I developed the inner strength which have forced the other never to enforce upon me any difference based on gender. So I cannot tell you that I suffered from any difference. I would not have allowed it. So I wanted to do science, and especially biological science. So I'm very happy to be in the Faculty of Science, where all basic science, all fundamental studies should be done, are done here, especially in Cairo University, to which I belong and which I love and respect so much. I think that the most important part of my life and career was the opportunity of getting a scholarship, a government, again government, Egyptian government, to whom I owe so much, a funded scholarship to study to the PhD degree in Prague, in at that time Czechoslovakia, in the Institute of Molecular Genetics. And here I was among the very first specialists regarding the Faculty of Science to study the science of immunology. I had my PhD degree in 75. I returned, and then I started the introduction of the science of immunology in the Faculty of Science, Cairo University, and then from which it went, it was to every university in Egypt and even in the Arab land. Subject of immunology, I was enough lucky to have the scholarship there. I did not choose it, I did not know it, because it did not exist in Egypt. The science immunology was not existent. So I learned it, and I worked very hard, very strongly, in order to be sure to introduce it. And also, I have trained and directed toward MSc degree and PhD degree very many students. here you find all these the professors where my former students, MSc and PhD, there are at least 10 of them, okay? And so with this many personnel, with the continuous teaching year after year after year, the immunology finally was introduced in the curriculum of the Faculty of Science, in the master's degree and then in the undergraduate course.
Elridi was the first scientist to teach immunology at Cairo University.
I think that no, my long journey is useless. I think my life is useless. The life of many scientists have been wasted because the first and only solution, the only right solution, is to establish something like a company, a body, which is able to transform scientific idea, scientific achievement into commercial products which are of use. If you miss this link, if this link is missing, so every effort, every result is useless. So every life is useless. Correct? This is the first thing we must do. This is the first thing we must do. I will give you an example of the difficulties. There is a single place where scientific achievement can be immediately made into commercial products which are of use for the economy and especially for development, especially of military intervention. And it is the Nile University because of their type of study. They study in computer and in communication, very delicate subject, and they have the ability, together with the smart village, the ability to make the scientific achievement into a product. And you see what is the result. The result is that they are aimed to be distracted. This is the point. So, for example, there are professors in the National Institute, the National Research Institute, who have achieved or nearly to achieve a vaccine against hepatitis virus C. Hepatitis virus C attacks 20 million persons. There is a possibility of developing a vaccine. Nevertheless, Dr. Al-Awadi, Professor Al-Awadi, who is not a no one, he has had very high state awards, so he's very well known. Nevertheless, with his vaccine against hepatitis C, he's entirely isolated. There is no one here to help him, no one here even to fund him. His fund is based on charity. So if this is the situation, what is the immediate result? The immediate result is that someone come and laugh at you, can come and exploit you. So Professor Mustafa Al-Awadi, he is a perfection awardee. He has almost near a vaccine against hepatitis virus C. No one cares about him. So you allow someone like Dr. Zuwail, who is in chemistry physics, to make something because he doesn't know well what is virus C, hepatitis virus C, or what, to make a joke of us, saying that after destroying the Nile University and building his tower, okay, he will do something, will come for hepatitis virus C. We have almost the vaccine, and here's someone who come to make a joke of us. You see, we deserve that. So what about this joke? It destroys Nile University, who is the only one which is able to make its finding into economical products. Number two, he takes all the money awarded to science. Third, he increases the isolation of Dr. El Awadi. He decreases its size. He decreases its importance. I mean, so where is the mistake? The mistake is that our inability to handle scientific ideas, scientific findings into products of use for commerce. Important events was our study for 20 years period in reptilian immunology, in the immunity of reptiles, of lizards, of snakes, of which our country is so rich, and they're not very common in developed countries, so this study was not known. No information was available about the immunity of reptiles, and we have gone so far and so wide. So as our team here in Cairo University was the foremost and the first in the world in the study of reptilian immunology. I have finished the study when I went so far as to go to very deep into information of this lizard, and I found it is more than enough. But I left the field in 1990. So I left the field 23 years ago. Until of today, there are still referring to our work. And we are still considered the first and best team in reptilian immunology in the world. And all the other studies, not in reptiles only, but in other animals, have confirmed our findings. A great reputation in scientific integrity based on reptilian immunology. And it is through reptilian immunology that I have taught so many students to obtain their master's degree and their PhD degree, and in the meantime also introduced, as I told you, the curriculum of immunology in the Faculty of Science. And as I had many 65 master students, 35 PhD students, they went to the other faculty in other universities to also teach immunology. Many have gone to Arabic university, where now immunology is a normal curriculum, is in Faculty of Science everywhere. We went very deep, and we have discovered important thing in the immunology of reptiles. This is not a trivial matter. But then in 1990, there was something has come to Egypt. This thing which came to Egypt was called the Schistosomiasis Research Project. It was a $40 million provided by USAID together with the Ministry of Health. And it was sought to promote schistosomiasis studies, study in schistosomes, development of vaccine and drug against schistosomes. As you know very much, that the funding is very important in directing research, and also the importance of the subject. So when I thought that was more than enough for reptiles now, and I have obtained enough experience to study something more difficult, and also the funding proposed by what is called the SRP, and so I have changed my career from reptilian immunology to the study of schistosomes. So the first 20 years were dedicated to reptilian immunology, to building science and research in the Faculty of Science, especially in the Department of Zoology. And the second period started in 1990, when I did not work in the Faculty of Science, but at Baxera, in the research department at the time, which was directed by Dr. Nabil Gerges, late Nabil Gerges. And then I have studied there with the SRP, the biology of schistosomes, and study towards development of a vaccine against schistosomiasis. It started there. So the SRP, which is Schistosomiasis Research Project, which was in union between United USAID and the Ministry of Health. It unfolded, it ended into closing the schistosomiasis unit at Namru. I fought very hard against this closing, but I failed to prevent it. And the unit was closed, and actually, gradually, Namru was entirely closed to Egyptian. And here there is a research center which belongs to the Ministry of Defense of the United States, and no Egyptian can step, and no one can tell what is going on here. So these were one of the best results of this SRP. And I remember very well that they have said at one moment around 1996 that the SRP is now closed and we are going to gather now. And I remember very much the diapositive, they doing this with their finger. We are going to the SVGP, something like this, for the vaccine, something. These things which remind me very much of Dr. Zuwail, who were also saying my town and my tower and my thing. It ended into stopping entirely all efforts, all funding, every type of funding, every type of study of schistosomiasis.
Professor Elridi has devoted a large part of her research to the development of a vaccine against schistosomiasis, which is also known as bilharzia. This disease affects over 200 million people around the world.
If we develop a 100% effective, 100% sterilizing vaccine, then the efforts will be due in two groups. One of them in the Faculty of Science, which I am directed, and the major one, the senior researcher here, is Dr. Hatem Tallima, here I'm present, which is directing major experiments in this. And also the greatest help and the greatest support is given by Mr. Abdel Badia, Sayyid Fouda. Without his effort, without his dedication, without his ingenuity, we could not have made all the experiments we have done. I think that we shall progress far. This is the only, it is a very small group, but very dedicated, very intelligent group of three of us only in the Faculty of Science. The second part is that directed by for Dr. Fouad Youssef, who is the director of the schistosomiasis biological supply unit, which provide us with Circaria, with worms. Without this unit, no one could do any work in schistosomiasis. With his effort and with the effort of Dr. Tallima, of Mr. Abdel Badia, I think that in a very near future, we shall have very, very good news to tell to the scientific community and to Egypt.
Understanding the biology of this parasite, he has high hopes that a vaccine will be developed within the next few months.
Thank you.
Rush Qarridi has been awarded L'Oréal UNESCO for Women in Science 2010 Laureate for Africa and the Arab States for her contribution to the development of a vaccine to eradicate the cycle of Bilharzia.
So the Chisholm Research Project, USAID funded, and their intervention in the Ministry of Health actually unfolded into a delight, into a nightmare. The first of them was the closing of Nimru 3 in the face of all Egyptian scientists, and gradually it ended by we don't know, and no one in Egypt can tell you what is going on. And they had huge facilities, of which also we don't know what they're doing. And in the time of the swine flu, you remember that they were the only laboratory which is able to see what's happening, but I cannot also remember very much health. So one of the fruits of this intervention in the Ministry of Health was the closing of Nimru into secret places, doing whatever they wanted to do. The second intervention was not less dramatic, as I told you. This was a program between the USAID and the Ministry of Health. The Ministry of Health at this time was in control of Vaxera, the only institution in Egypt which is responsible for vaccines and sera, which is very important also for all the African country and also Arab countries. The energy of these people which have been empowered by this project was so large, so big, that it ended by actually destructing Vaxera. Vaxera now does not produce any vaccine, do not produce any sera, they only produce any sera. Everything is imported. They have really broken Vaxera into nothingness. And if we are into war or they can threaten us by not sending us vaccine, and then you will know at this end what has happened actually to vaccine. I think that we would never been defeated military. I think that the only way to defeat us is through the vaccine of Vaxera. And you have heard now of the young boy who was killed because a simple scorpion has bitten it. Despite that, in Australia, I have read lately that a boy was bitten by the worst, the deadliest cobra in Australia, and he was saved because they had the right anti-serum. But we don't have them, and the boy died. And we shall never be military defeated ever, but through Vaxera, through the lack of ability to make vaccine, we could be very easily defeated and brought to our knees. This intervention, this American intervention. So why I'm very much worried about the American intervention through Dr. Zewail, through the building of his tower or his city of science. I don't believe much, and I think that it will unfold into nightmare. Anyhow, we want the president what he has done in 100 years. We want to remember that also ask his whale what he has done in 100 weeks at least. And we have to mark the time and see whatever he says, at least to remember.
There was another very good fruit which unfolded from the SRP, which is to stopping every possible work, every possible fund on schistosomiasis. And schistosomiasis has ended into being a completely neglected disease. There was no fund, no money, no care, nothing. All they did is to put in the head of the Ministry of Health that there is no more schistosomiasis in Egypt, so that Egyptian scientists stop studying it. And it is true, even in our institute, Theodor Bilhart's Research Institute, who should work on schistosomiasis, most of his work now is directed to hepatitis virus C. But I am not the type to change direction easily. So there was no fund for schistosomiasis. No one was interested in schistosomiasis. No one wanted schistosomiasis. But I nevertheless, I was able to carry on. Very few people that work in vaccine against schistosomiasis in the world. We are a leading group, and we have went very far. We have gone last. The protection using a vaccine against infection was usually in the level of 40%. I will tell you not of what I hope to achieve, I will tell you of what I have achieved now. What has been published in press now, is that we have achieved reproducibly a protection of 80%. This was an addition to science. If it were from the United States or from Israel, you would have heard a lot of noise. But from Egypt, it will be heard too. And with a lot of noise too, but it will take more time. Without this body able to take the scientific finding and scientific idea, not only of scientists, but also of normal Egyptians who are so creative in their mind, and to make it into product which is helps the economy, the industry, and the military. I would say to anyone, young and old, man or woman, be do something else. I have no hope at all in the Egyptian government now. Unfortunately, they're not very much related to science, exactly like the earlier one. This is very strange that the previous government was not interested in science, despite military government should be the most interested in science, because there is no way to promote military forces except science, so it is very strange. So now it is not a military dictatorship, but it is quite different one. They are very much involved in women and in girls and in in trivialities like that. And I cannot give them any advice, because it's useless.
Elridi is not only a great scientist, but also a caring mother for her only son.
My name is Dr. Hatem Talhima. I am actually delighted to talk here about Professor Dr. Ashiq Aridi in specific and her magnificent work. I will just give a brief part of the history that I really joined the group here, the lab, 12 years ago, specifically in the summer of 2000, just after I graduated from the American University in Cairo, chemistry department. I had the honor and pleasure to join the lab of Professor Dr. Rashika, and since then I was her student and co-worker in her magnificent work, specifically for developing a vaccine against schistosomiasis. Really not enough words are enough to describe Dr. Rashika in many aspects. Just let's talk, which is very important for me actually, about her science. Knowing her from all of these years, I would just tell it straightforward. She is a first-class scientist. a scientist that is comparable to the top class scientists in top universities in all the world. Exceptional because it is coming actually from an Egyptian university. She always refuses to go outside or work in different universities in the States or in Europe. She never got to take an opportunity, for example, like many professors take, to go to Gulf State to get some money teaching there. She was dedicated totally for her research work, and this is actually very much joined to her background about the work itself. She is very much dedicated to find a vaccine for a disease that affects millions of poor people. She is very compassionate about that. She is very much joining her personal and spiritual and intellectual and emotional direction in the life with her work. She would work not only in immunology as science in general, but she wants very much to link it to the society and to the poor people, which very much shows not only her political and psychological view, but her spiritual compassion as well for the people. Just this background shows you how much that she is totally working in total dedication for her work, using all his intelligent excellence, her intellectual capacities, her scientific abilities, with a very dedicated mode to work on. And I would say this is the core of her success. Though all of the hindrances she faces throughout a bureaucratic regime, the lack of any encouragement from the formal institution, the general atmosphere of a non-scientific environment, even in the Faculty of Science, the lack of presence of a scientific community that could help or integrate in this work, all of these hindrances and also external hindrances from the outside work, where you can find very much some kind of fighting for any kind of scientific progress coming from Egypt, a kind of doubt and suspicion about how much this coming excellent work coming from a lab from such a poor and non-progressed countries. All of these hindrances have never altered Dr. Eridi for progressing a great step toward the vaccine against schistosomiasis. I had the chance to work with her. I learned from her a lot, both on the scientific level and on the human level. The most important thing I really learned, I would say, from her is extreme integrity of the scientific work, extreme dedication to the cause for finding a solution to the poor people concerning this disease, the use of all the God-given gifts for the help of the others, and using science in that is a major open through, and it affected not only my scientific life, but my personal life as well. Another thing which is quite interesting as well is that Professor Eridi is actually also my mother, my real mother. This is very interesting, of course, for you. I would just give a small background about her as a mom. Well, it's really hard to talk about that, but I would say she is really an exceptional human being in every aspect of the world. She affected very much me, of course. She has an influence actually on everybody who deals with her. So needless to say how the effect could be on her child. The most important part that she gave for me, which is something I would just take as a debt on all my shoulders, all my life, an atmosphere of open liberty, which is completely incomparable. And in the same time, a concern about the small details which has to do with my physical welfare and my psychological welfare. So the atmosphere of liberty with the very taking care of the detail that opened for me a physical normal growth with a psychological health has helped me a lot in my life. She was always, she never constrained me in any endeavor I take. I have sometimes been a little bit odd. I have been a little bit revolutionary, more or less, different in many aspects. All what I found is a total acceptance, a total taking of the way with a great respect and honor, and always an atmosphere that helped me very much progress in my life. An extreme loving personality like her, giving me all the love, and in the same time giving me all the liberty and freedom to go outside the life. So I'm an only child, but I don't have any problems or any side effects of the only child syndromes. I mean, I have a very loving mother, but in the same time, I'm not the son of my mother, as they say. So this dialect is very important concerning the buildup of my personality. Another aspect as well is that my political views and my sociological views towards society have been very much affected by her attitude. So she not only shaped my personality in that context, but as well she affected very much my political and sociological views towards society throughout my growth, actually. Why? Because her very much concern in dealing with the poor and with the deprived and with the weakened population have really affected me deeply and contributed a lot into my understanding of the society and actually my future action toward it. It would be very direct to say that she affected my career as well, as I chose to go into a chemistry major, which is a science major, which I find totally not true. She didn't really affect my entry in chemistry because I had a born love for chemistry, but she affected more the other aspect of my personality which are not quite evident maybe in this lab, which is my political view, my love for reading and for philosophy and for literature. Why? Because I remember very well that when I was about 3 years old and even less, she used to read each night for me a different novel or some kind of, you know, this children anecdotes and so on. So she developed in me a sense of love to reading and knowledge that actually is the core of my building up of my knowledge afterwards. And that was really the cornerstone of my understanding of the world in philosophy, literature, and definitely my engaging in politics afterwards. So yeah, of course, entering chemistry was somehow related to her science, but I didn't find it as direct as my love in other aspects of life. So in general, I would say these are the main points. Nowadays, we are working together. I have the pleasure and honor to be under her direction in her great mission, as well as that we are partners as well in our views towards society and public work within the revolution and afterwards, and as well we are like friends talking about each day the news, the political events inside Egypt, the Arab world and outside, discussing the different position, discussing the different views, and how can we progress from here. I just would say I love you, Mom.
I love you more than you love me 100 times, and I wish to tell you that my care and my love and the sense of freedom, I was always very much interested in surrounding him, has evolved into leadership, a very important leadership now in the revolution and in the Revolutionary Party, where he's one of the major director in it. And actually, he's so wise and so good in spiritual findings and political direction, that from the bottom of my heart and very often than not, I tell him, I call him master. Thank you. Yes, he also, beside looking at my son growing and developing into a real leader in every aspect, then I like also very much reading. And like we are movie goers. We go to many films weekly. We knew every film, international and national, which came up. But this was before the revolution. After that, we are very much taken in, and so we are less of movie goers. But I like very much also music. My mother has taught me how to enjoy operas. And I like classic music, slice music, but also I enjoy the songs of our singers.
Schistosomiasis is not a disease of the city, it is a disease of the rural areas. It is very important to remind that this is an infection essentially which is very dangerous for children. When they start playing or working even in fields where there is fresh water, they are exposed to the infective stage of the parasite. The infective stage is issued from snails. The snails live only in fresh water. I don't think that anyone take care of him before 5 years more, and he will be already a little too late. He's barefoot in the middle of the field where there is infected snails.
They depend on God to prevent infection, to cure them. When they die, they said it is the will of God. So to eliminate this infection, it is not enough to have drugs. It is very important to eliminate the transmission itself, and this would not be possible except with the vaccine on which I am spending my time, and I'm so happy to do that. Really, it is a disease of the poorest in developing countries.
A woman from Egypt can make a big difference in our society.